Hello everyone and welcome to my Java programming tutorial. In this video we will talk about mathematical functions. So let's take a look. Let's jump onto the PowerPoint slides. Okay, so we have mathematical functions, characters and strings. So I have divided this video into three different videos. So this video we will only talk about mathematical functions. So this is chapter 4. Let's get started. So in Java you already have built-in method for the math class. So you have that math class. Most of it, I would say that everything, what you need in that math, whether you are creating a calculator for physics, chemistry, or you are creating a scientific calculator, like with your programming in Java, you need cos, tan, sine, like all the functions are already built in. You don't have to do any much of that coding. You just need to call those functions or those methods. So let's take a look what we have. So that's a math class. Again, just like Scanner is a class in Java, Math is also a class in Java. But to use that Math class, you don't have to create those objects. So we have class name constants. Class constants are like pi, which you have already seen in our previous example, like from chapter 1 or 2, where we have seen how you declare constants. So you have trigonometric methods, exponent, rounding, minimum, max, absolute. Like these are the most common methods you need when you are creating something mathematical, I would say. So these are all the methods. This is how you call. So if you want to calculate a sine, cos, tan, a cos, a sin, a tan, like you just need to call this method and pass the double value. So this is a chart which shows you that what is the value these methods require. So they are based on double data type. On the right side, you can see examples how you are making a call. So you have to say math with capital M dot. As you put a dot in Eclipse, it will give you a list of all the methods which exist in that math class. So as you can see, these are trigonometric methods. So you have dot sign. So you pass 0 and the value return is 0.0. Because as you can see, the value required over here is a double. But you have passed an integer, but the value return will always be a double. Same with sign. Cause, so you can combine. As you can see, you are combining two methods in one statement and the values returned are in double. So let's move on to the next one. You have exponent, log 10, power, square root. So you may see, like for Java 1 level, because these the trigonometric functions you may not meet in this level that much, other than in Pearson. You will use those methods in Pearson, but not for your exams or not for your basic class or understanding of the math functions. The most popular methods for math are this power function, which you will use a lot, this square root, because you need to ask the square root. So whenever you're making a call to power, this is the first value you pass and the second value you pass. So for the first value, that's the base, and the second value is the exponent. So it means 2 power 3, the value return is 8.0. remember, math functions return a double. So again, for math dot square root, when you have when you need a square root of something, so you are only passing one value, and the square root for 4 is 2.0, and for power you need to pass at least 2 values. Okay, so these are just charts. I am going over like what are the things you need to make sure when you are making a call to some of the math functions. Rounding method. Okay, so this is a little difficult to understand. So we have seal, floor, rent, round, and then long round. So what these methods are, they are rounding methods. Okay, so depending on what type of software you are creating or what are your conditions, you have to pick one of these methods to apply or get your answers. So like from the seal, it's from the ceiling, I would say. Just take the hint from seal, is from ceiling, and it rounds up to its nearest integer. Floor, by the name floor, it's a floor, it's down, it rounds down to the nearest integer. So a seal and floor both goes like to the opposite of each other. So seal and floor, ceiling rounding up, floor rounding down to its nearest integer. What rent does is it's round to its nearest integer. If x is equally close to two integers, the even value is returned. So equally close to two integers will be when you have 3.5 something. So the value returned will be an even number. So which one is even? If I say 3.5, so the next value, if I round up, it will be 4. If I round down, it will be 3. So it means 4.0 will be returned. And same with if I have 4.5, the value return will be the nearest integer. It returns an even number, so it will return 4 in that case. We will see a couple of more examples in our next slide with the values. And what round does, like simple round from your math function, you are using and you are typecasting round returns an integer value. As you can see, rest of them, they return a double. As they can see in the statement, they have mentioned that they return double value, but round return an integer. Okay, so these are some functions. You may think like, for a point of view, like, okay, it's not that hard to remember. When I'm writing code, I can see what value I need or return. These are confusing when you have multiple choice questions. There, it will give you a hard time that you have four options and then you need to remember that if the method is math.round, the value return will be an integer. So then we have long round. Again, it's the same thing as round, but returns a longer integer if you are applying that method on to a longer integer. So these are some rounding method examples. So as you can see, math.seal round up. So if you have 2.1, value return will be 3.0. So it doesn't mean that it must be above 2.5 to round up. No, that's with the round method. With seal, when you are applying seal, it will automatically round up. If you have math.seal 2.0, it will be 2.0 because that's the maximum you can go. With the negative numbers, it works the same way. Then you have floor 2.1. Round down, right? So it will round down to 2.0, and same value 2.0 will remains 2.0. Let's move on to rint, which was a little bit confusing. So we have rint. Remember rint? It will round to its closest integer. Okay, so closest integer, if it is equally close to two integers, it will pick the even number. So let's take a look. When you have 2.1, the closest one is 2.0. 2.0, it remains 2.0. If you have negative 2.0, it's the negative remains. Okay, let's move on this part. 2.5. Now think, 2.5, closest integer, equally close to 3.0 and equally close to 2.0, right? So now which value to pick? It returns the even number. So 3.0 is not even, so we will go with 2.0. The value return will be 2.0 with 2.5. Okay, so this is how it works, and round works the same way, like just simple math round. So these are some examples. You can, if you want to test these values, just copy and paste, like just copy math.seal 2.0 and apply like all different numbers on Eclipse and see what, if you want to test any other values, what will be the answer. Most common methods we have over here, min, max, and absolute. So when you have a big programming questions, which you will see after loops, chapter loops we will do, then there you will realize that how many these methods, string methods, character method, and map methods are useful in solving those programming questions, because these methods will be saving your time. For example, finding a minimum number, you don't have to write if and else conditions. You just call if you're comparing two values to check which value is the minimum or which value is the maximum. You just call the math method, like you just pass two values and it only works with two values. So if you are saying math.max, you just pass a comma b, and it can be an integer, it can be double. So depending on the value, what values you are comparing, it will return that maximum or minimum value. And what ABS method does, it's an absolute method. When your code required that you must enter a positive number, but you know users, right? The client, they may enter a negative number, so your code should not crash. Or maybe you're like, I can, if user enter a negative number, convert that number into a positive number and return the result. So here you have that absolute method to convert whatever the value you are taking from user. Apply that math.absolute. So if the value is positive, it will remain positive. But if it's a negative value, it will convert that negative value to a positive number and apply whatever the formula or equation you are thinking of to apply. So these are some most common method, min, max, and absolute, which you will use a lot. These methods should be on your fingertips. Like if I have to find the minimum number of two, math.min, math.max, and just to make sure that if you have need a positive number, you can call math dot absolute. Okay, so moving on to the next one, the another important factor of the math class we have is the random, which you have already seen in our previous examples, in our previous video, how to use random. And random is important when you are creating games. So games all like a game of dice, game of coins, any random games or card games, anything you are working with the games in which you require random thing, or you are rock, paper, scissors, there you need random, right? You are playing with computer. So there you need random. And it's not that hard to write the math.random class. So you are just creating. So this is one way of using random. There is another random class already built in java.util package. You can also create that random object, and by creating that random object, you can use that random, which we will see again in a couple of examples in the future. So don't worry, you will see that phase as well. So this is the easiest way. You just call math.random, and times 10 means that's the maximum you can go, and 10 is exclusive, so 10 is not counted. So if you just do this part, math.random times 10, it will give you a double number as well. So to make sure that you only need integers, just to remind you, this is from, we have covered this part in our subtraction quiz video, where we have typecasted our math.random with integer because we were creating a subtraction quiz for a first grade student. Again, for first grade, we were making sure that it's a single digit. To make a single digit, we set a limit. We will go till 10. If you want to count 10 as well, it will be 11 over here, because whatever the number you write, that number is not counted. That will be one less of that number is the limit. And if you want to set the starting position, like you are like, I'm creating a subtraction quiz for a second grade and my starting will be 50 to 200, something like this. So this is where you put the starting point, whatever the number you put, 50 plus, and then rest of the statement, the live with the limit. And how this is created, like when you are putting a starting point as well, this returns a random integer between 50 to 99. So how 50 to 99? But you are, this is like, I think this is a general formula which is represented a plus b, excluding what a plus b is. So this is your a, the starting position, and this is your b, the ending position. So this is how it works. So that's how it's going. And 50 plus 50 is 100. So as you can see, it goes 99. So 100 is not counted. Okay, so that's it for the random math.absolute and min max method. Let's take a look on Eclipse real quick what we have. So let's take a value, and int value, let's say int n equals to input.next int. Let's say we are taking value a and b, two integers from user, and what I'm doing is, to see the output, you have to put the statement inside of your system.out.print. So what I've written is system.out.print, I'm calling my math.min method, it will return me the minimum number, and the value, two values, I don't know what those two values will be, so let's run, as we will take it from user, so it will not run. So let's display a message for system.out.println, so that user know that what user have to enter. Enter, let's run. Okay, so enter two integers, let's say enter 5 and 8, and 5 is returned because I said math.min. Let's make a change and make it math.max. Run again, and let's enter the same values, so see 5 and 8, and value returned this time is 8. So this is how you will be seeing the output. So I have just tested this Eclipse code to show you how you will be seeing the output for math.max. Otherwise, you can take a look at all the methods over here. You can take a picture and you can just test all the methods, or you can just say math dot and you will see all the methods listed in Eclipse. So let me show you that part. Okay, so you don't have to, one thing, you don't have to do it in system.out.println. You can create a variable as well. Result equals to, you can say math dot, and as I said math dot, here you have all the method listed which were not even in your slides, so you can take a look what those method does. Here you have, so you just pick a method and assign, and make sure when you are over here, I have set as integer, so there are some methods which you have seen in your PowerPoint slides that they return a double, so they will give you error if your return type data type over here is int. So you have to make sure that if you're calling a method math.seal, floor, they are returning double. So over here, the result data type must be double. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you. Bye-bye.